I'm going to show you how to make a mason bee house. This is your typical way, using a block of wood. This is a 4x4. You can use a 6x6. The holes will be, the diameter is 3/8. They're every 3/4 inches. And you'll drill them out 6 to 7 inches deep. And that's your typical mason bee house. So that is one way. The way that I'm thinking about trying is I've come across this cardboard. As you can see, it's got deep holes in it. They're just over 3/8. I will probably line these with parchment paper so they're easy to clean out. And the idea with this is I may double it up, which will give it 8 inches. The idea with this is it makes it a lot lighter, a lot easier to hang, and probably a lot easier to stick in some spots in our soffits and that. So I'll show this in this video, or I might make a separate video depending how long this video takes. I'm going to use these 1x6s for the roof. It's cedar. I still don't trust it to be 100% waterproof, so I am going to wrap the outside of my cutout in my 4x4 with this waterproof trim flashing. It's peel and stick. Use it around windows and stuff. So I'm going to wrap this, and then I'll put the roof on. That way, if this gets waterlogged or leaks, it still won't get the inside of this wet. Just plain old parchment paper. What I'm doing is I'm cutting them about 2 inches wide and then about 2 inches longer than the box. And then you find yourself a pencil or a rod that will push through, and you wrap the parchment paper around your pencil or whatever you use nice and tightly. Once you have it wrapped, you'll then push it through the hole. And then pull out the rod. There's the front. The front will be flush when you're done. I'm just going to leave these like this until I'm done. And the backs, I'll cut them off and then bend them over like that. That way, if you want to clean out the boxes, you'll just pull off the back end and then you can just pull the straws out.